Hi, I'm Dr. Lee. Welcome to Practical Pain Management. In this video, I'm going to share a case of pain relieving treatment of tennis elbow and intra-articular steroid injection. He has suffered from chronic right lateral elbow pain and posterior elbow pain for 1 year. He has undergone several injection treatment and physical therapy for a long time, but it did not work well. On the physical examination, he felt pain on the passive flexion and extension test. He also felt pain on the resisted wrist extension test. There are several pathologies that explain the pain on the passive extension test. One common condition is intra-articular pathology. Deep tendon tear or radial collateral ligament tear is one of the common pathologies. Most of my patients want pain reduction immediately, but whole body injection would not provide acute pain reduction. It rather worsens pain transiently, so I have to reduce the pain first. But there are several options to consider. One is that it has to facilitate better prognosis. Second, it has to be sufficient to relieve pain. High concentration of steroid worsens the tendon condition, especially particulate steroid. And don't forget to continue to regeneration treatment. Let me explain about primary pain relieving treatment. First, I have to make hypertonic solution. I mix 100 ml of 50% of dextrose with 30 ml of 4% lidocaine. In this solution, it contains approximately 40% of dextrose and 0.8% of lidocaine. Second, mix hypertonic dextrose solution with low concentration of steroid. I prepare 2 ml of hypertonic solution with 0.05 ml of dexamethasone palmitate for tendon injection and 2 ml of hypertonic solution with 0.8 ml of dexamethasone palmitate for intra-articular injection. Third, injection process. I put in 0.2 to 0.3 ml of prepared mixed solution in pathologic elbow tendon and 2 ml of hypertonic solution with 0.8 ml of dexamethasone palmitate for intra-articular injection. Ultrasound diagnosis. There are cortical irregularities on the lateral facet of lateral epicondyle and low echogenesis of extensor tendon. There is a mild effusion in anterior coronoid fossa and posterior olecranon fossa. Let's go to clinical practice. Please watch my staff how hard it is working to clean the surgical site. To try to sterilize the surgical site one more, we do every procedure to make infection zero. Watch carefully every step that we do before the injection procedure every time. I draw hypertonic solution into two different syringes. First, I'm going to inject it into the common extensor tendon. I am peppering a solution into the tendon. Peppering technique is sometimes used to inject the autologous blood. This involves the inserting the needle into the tendon, injecting some of the blood, withdrawing without emerging from the skin, slightly redirecting and reinserting. Now, I'm going to move to intra-articular injection. Me, my staff, and patients cooperate to make a suitable position. I have to clean the surgical site with alcohol chlorhexidine solution one more. Many movements need the non-dominant hand to hold and control the needle. In my case, the left hand is the non-dominant side. So we have to train our non-dominant hand control to make a more meticulous approach. Thank you for watching. See you again.